Senator Seward.
Thank you, Mr. Acting Deputy President. I rise to take note of the document the Australian Law Reform Commission's Equality, Capacity and Disability in Commonwealth Law's final report 124 and the summary report in August 14. This report, which I've, a number of people have been eagerly awaiting, I'm pleased to see it's finally been tabled and makes some very important points, all of which it's a very thorough report I haven't had time to consider, but there are some important points that jump out to me straight away. And this inquiry is about ensuring, it says in the report, that this inquiry is about ensuring people with disability have an equal right to make decisions for themselves. It is about respecting people's dignity, autonomy and independence while supporting them to make their own recommendations where such support is needed. And what more important day to be talking about this when we've been talking about the BSWAT legislation this morning that talks about supportive decision making. And it says the ALRC recommends that the reform of relevant Commonwealth, state and territory laws should be consistent with the following national decision-making principles. Principle one, the equal right to make decisions. And it says that all adults have an equal right to make decisions that affect their lives and to have those decisions respected. Principle two, support. Persons who require support in decision-making must be provided with access to the support necessary for them to make, communicate and participate in decisions that affect their lives. Point three, will, preferences and rights. The will, preferences and rights of persons who require decision-making support must direct decisions that affect their lives. And principle four, safeguards. Laws and legal frameworks must contain appropriate and effective safeguards in relation to interventions for persons who require decision-making support, including to prevent abuse and undue influence. I'd also make that point with what we will be viewing on Four Corners tonight. These are absolutely essential principles. The report goes on to make a series of recommendations, all of which I can't do justice on in the space of time I've got. But it says, supported decision-making Commonwealth laws. It talks about a Commonwealth decision-making model that encourages supported decision-making must be introduced into relevant Commonwealth laws and legal frameworks in a form consistent with the principles I've just been articulating. It also talks about needing to change the National Disability Insurance Scheme to ensure that the principles and objects in the National Disability Insurance Scheme Act 2013 should be amended to ensure consistency with these principles. And very importantly, it also talks about the Social Security Act needing to be amended to incorporate those principles and access to justice. This is particularly important when you're talking about people with disability, and I'm thinking of people with cognitive impairment who have been in incarceration for indeterminate periods of time. It talks about the Crime Act 1914 should be amended to provide that a person cannot stand trial if that person cannot be supported to understand the information relevant to the decisions that will have to make in the course of proceedings, retain the information to the extent necessary to make the decisions in the course of the proceedings, and it makes a number of points. It also talks about weigh that information as part of the process of making decisions or communicate the decisions in some way. It also says state and territory laws governing the consequences of a determination that a person is ineligible to stand trial should provide for A, limits on the period of detention that can be imposed, and B, regular periodic review of these detention orders. This is absolutely critical information, and I urge everybody that's got an interest in access to justice, in the rights of people with disability, as the opening says, in the dignity, autonomy, and independence of people people with disability. This makes essential reading. I've only just had time to dip into these recommendations now, but it's a very thorough report, and it's going to have an impact on all our laws, both state, Commonwealth and territory, across the range of people's lives. Please, I urge the government to take these recommendations on board and look at how they're going to start implementing them.
Thank you, Senator Seward. The Senate is now considering